This is the feedback from a BP and anxiety patient. He has been free of blood pressure medicines for the last 3 to 4 months, and his normal blood pressure these days is 110/70. The person mentions about not taking medicines at 1 minute 20 seconds of this video. Hello.
Hello.
Haji.
Zaruna from Chennai.
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, what happened last 2 weeks before I got some cold. After that, last 2 weeks onwards, I'm getting dizziness always while standing, sitting, while driving.
Mm-hmm.
Even lying down also, I'm getting dizziness.
Mm-hmm.
I went to the ENT specialist.
Mm-hmm.
He told some infection is there in that ears. That's why.
Mm-hmm.
But this is the first time I feel the dizziness. That's
mm-hmm.
why I call you. Is it possible to any?
But meanwhile, earlier you had
anxiety, anxiety, and yeah, anxiety and BP. But
yeah.
BP is everything normal. Last 3 to 4 months I checked, is everything normal right now? 110/70, and
you're taking medicine
also
for that?
No. I'm
no
not
medicine.
Taking any medicine.
Okay.
Because previously, one year back, I was taking medicine.
Mm.
After that, I slowly reduced, and I mean, 3/4 off, and 1/4. So weekly once, monthly once, just slowly I reduced.
Mm.
But last 3 to 4 months, I didn't take any medicine.
Okay, and you're feeling dizziness. What is your fluid intake for the last few days?
Fluid intake 3 to 4 glass of water whole day.
And you're calling from Chennai.
Chennai, yeah, right.
So, what is the weather there?
It's extreme cold.
Extreme cold?
Yeah.
What is the temperature? Less than 10?
It's approximately 9 to 10.
9 to 10. Okay. Okay. And you're taking 3 to 4 glasses. And what about tea intake and other fluids?
Other fluids? No, I'm not taking any juices. Like only the 4 glass of water I'm taking. That's all. I'm not taking any tea or coffee. Juice,
and this water, you're taking cold water or lukewarm or warm water?
It's normal water only, not hot water than cold water.
Do one thing, take one cup of tea for next 2-3 days.
Okay.
And for at least 1 day, you increase the water intake and take slightly hotter water.
Okay,
not
okay.
Very hot, but say better, more warm than lukewarm.
Okay.
Whatever.
And one more thing. I spoke with my anxiety specialist.
Mm-hmm.
What he said? He said the dizziness also caused by anxiety. It's everything
mm-hmm.
Because you as per my body, everything
mm-hmm.
is related to that anxiety. The anxiety.
What is your walk and rest? Are you doing any walk and rest?
Yeah, every before going to bed, I'm doing that walk and rest.
Five minutes.
I will totally rest five times and walk 5 times, 5 minutes.
That means 50 minutes in the morning and evening.
Not only I'm doing evening.
Only in the evening, about 50 minutes.
25 minutes. 25 minutes walk 20. And 20 minutes rest.
And what about your food intake? Have you increased food intake or?
No, I'm not increased. But what I'm doing, what I did morning time, I'm using some health mix, like all that increment, all the ingredients. I'll put some groundnuts and everything healthy food.
Mm-hmm.
I'm taking some homemade mix.
Okay.
And afternoon is normal rice and some.
You feeling hungry? Or you're
no,
just
no.
eating like that?
No. Now I'm good. I'm not feeling hungry. I'm not feeling tired. The only thing, the dizziness.
No, I mean, do you feel hunger or you just eat because it is time to eat?
No, I'm not hunger. Because the time to once the time reach, I start to eat.
Mm-hmm. You don't have any digestion problems?
Previously that, but last 3 to 4 months I don't have any digestion problem.
Okay, try to walk in the morning also for some time, at least for two three times at least, and try to walk every hour for 5 minutes.
Every hour for 5 minutes. Okay.
Whether you are able to lie down or not is another matter, but try to walk, and for next 2-3 days, take 1 cup of tea in the day, anytime.
Okay.
And for one day at least, increase your water intake to about 8-9 glasses, and this can be hot water, just for one day, not every day. And the idea is just to increase your urine output. After this 1 day, you can reduce your water intake to even less than 4 glasses of water. You can even take 2 glasses or 1 glass in the entire day for 2-3 days.
I'll do it.
Yeah. And how's your urine output?
Output is amazing. But I have one question. I saw your website. In the website, it's showing some high blood pressure, the lowering blood pressure. First day we have to take it. First day we have to take it 4 glasses of water, and the second day we have to stop at least 4 to 8 glasses of water first day. Second day is showing 24 to 36 hours. No need to take any
Actually,
water.
Actually, I am not updating my website on a very regular basis. So the whole idea is to vary the amount of water that one drinks. That is the main idea, and no need to follow that strictly because everybody's needs are different. That is for general guidelines because people do want some specific things to be told. We are talking on phone, so we know better. So there's no need to look at that. Just whenever there is any problem, you just change the amount of water. So drinking more amount of water for one day will not do much harm.
Okay.
And at times, if you think like this dizziness and all that, you can take even for one day salt and water. Like you can add 1/4 spoon of salt to the water, each glass of water that you drink. So that will also help in increasing your energy levels, and that will take care of your anxiety or whatever dizziness you're seeing.
Okay, but I 100% sure. I mean, I'm damn sure that dizziness came for only the infection of my nose and the ears.
See, the infections are caused because of increase in the fluid, and increase in the fluid is caused because of some energy deficit. When your heart is not getting enough energy, or your vital organs are not getting enough energy, you don't produce enough energy in the body. And that leads to accumulation of fluids, that leads to the infection. The moment your energy levels go up, dizziness and infection, everything will go.
Okay. So and everything is based on the water. We have to, one day we can take it.
You can say it is water, or sometimes you can increase, at least one weekend you can increase your walk and rest. That will also increase your energy levels. Once the energy level goes up, everything will be all right. So if you do not find time, the other way of increasing the energy is by reducing your water intake.
Okay. So main, we have to take, that of walk and rest, that's the main thing, right?
That is the main thing. We have to increase the energy. Main thing is increase the energy in case you don't feel hungry. That means whatever you are eating, even you are not able to digest that. So you have to do something about that. Increasing the water intake will cause more pressure on the urine output. So maybe something will get cleaned up. Sometimes the toxins also build up, like whatever metabolic waste is there, that should also be cleaned. So what I told in the beginning also, every 10 to 15 days, increase the water intake to at least 2 liters or 2.5 liters.
Okay.
That takes care of the any metabolic waste which gets accumulated in the body.
Good. Okay. I understood. So I always thinking about the only water, not for that. Walk and rest. But here after this, I can give that walk and rest a preference.
Yes, and even for water also, you have to vary it. You have to at least increase for once in 10 days or 15 days.
Okay. I understood.
Okay.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.